Welcome back to Life of Boris channel, the one place where your opinion is heard and valued. So when people say, slow down, I will slow down for you. Also for those who do not speak the language so well, and for those who just like to see more content on screen at one time, I say boom, here is subtitles for you, no problem. To people like this, I do not have no idea what to say. And to this comrade, hell guess it, I gift you a lifetime of bliss and happiness for getting the game. For today, for the last game of this time's Slav Game Week, we are playing 35mm, which by the way is the exact size of caliber at which this channel hits the world with slavness. Welcome back to Slav Game Week, put on Ushanka and squat down, because today we take pictures in forest. Enjoy!
Yes, Boris!
.35mm is a game about the post-apocalyptic world, as most of the games seem to be in the last 10 years, but okay. You play as this guy, a man with a 35mm photo camera, taking pictures of random shit that he finds, only to realize later on that there was no film in the camera. Ooh. Or at least that's what it seems like, because all the pictures you take end up nowhere at all. And as if that was not bad enough, the whole forest is filled with these Chernobyl shrooms. These uncuttable sukas, блять. So okay, story of this game takes place in forests of Russia, as we can clearly tell from glorious Soviet car design. So main character Mr. I forget his name, is what seems to be a random wandering gopnik, who looks to have been sleeping under a tree for the last few months. But Mr. Gopnik here is not just random Slav, but he seems to be immune to the deadly virus that has killed most of the world's population. What a time to be alive. Overall, things are not that bad. Sometimes bear we try to attack, but they are usually so slow that you will have time to enjoy the moment. Other times there will be dogs attacking you, but happily there is a Kalashnikov nearby. Even though this is a post-apocalyptic game, there is no undead spawns of three spirits or zombie babushkas here. Only endless atmospheric environments, and the story more linear than Tetris. Most of the action scenes that come along are quick time events, but there is some casual shooting in between. If I would have to say, this game reminds me of Stalker. Not the game, but the movie, with railroad and endless wandering in forest, and ultimately a psychological ending, which you can easily find out by yourself, because this game is only 2 hours long. Right now there is a Steam sale for this game, so you can go buy it for an average ticket price of cinema, and walk through this interactive world by yourself.
Hello,
hello, this is comrade Boris, are you happy with your phone service? I guess not. Created by comrade Sergei, 35mm welcomes you into a world of workbenches, puzzles, betrayal, and Soviet-style outhouses that not even an axe can bring down. The speed at which this game plays out will leave you with enough time to have a cup of tea, to make some butter broad, explore environments in this game, and appreciate the amount of detail that has gone into this indie project. And check out the Soviet car models, with higher amount of detail than thread count on Russian carpet. So if you like to get lost in a world that is not necessarily that hostile, and explore places at your own pace, then this game is exactly for you. All 2 hours of it. Or you can just pay 100 hours of Stalker, no problem. Well, now you know. This game exists, go get it on Steam if you like. Let me know what you think of the new subtitle size. And Slav Game Week will return in another 6 months or something. Thank you for watching, stay Slav, my friends. I'll see you next time.
Ла-ла-ла-ла-ла-ла.